the world is rapidly aging, and as a practice, we need to face the challenges of the aging population and their demands. As our vision as a practice is to deliver the next generation of later living developments. There's a comfort, health and well-being are the main items that we are focusing on as a practice, and that will promote health for the residents of our developments, and in this case for Akoya.
When designing for seniors living or later living developments, we have a different set of considerations than we would on a normal residential development. These are generally around the space planning. There'll also be items such as connecting to community. In the case of Akoya, we're creating a new neighbourhood, a new community, and it's really about how do we connect people that would have been in a community currently, and moving into a new development obviously creates some obstacles. So creating spaces where we can invite them together, where they can share new friendships, new hobbies, but also in terms of the apartments they're living in. So consideration to how they might age in place, allowing there to be flexibility within the apartments, extended spaces, and really thinking about the demands of a resident as they age. They may be cognitive change, it may be a physical change, and they're all aspects that we go back to basics on with design and focus on that really. It's really the person focus, people focus design.
If I can add to that, actually, I mean, this beautiful and powerful. I mean, I think the design is a powerful tool, right? And we can use design in many ways. So the way we've used design and evidence-based design is to promote health and help their residents to live longer in their apartments and their communities. I think that's the power of design. I think when we apply that to later living design, that becomes really important because the residents that at their age, they actually need to stay active and healthy. And this is what this development can do for them.
For the interior design, it was really about connecting to the building, making sure that we utilised all of the view aspects. It's an incredible location. The space planning was really about grasping all of those views, and the views are sort of city views, district views, and on a really great day you can see out to the Blue Mountains. So we focused it on the aesthetic, on really connecting to that. There's a beautiful verticality in the landscaping that runs up and down the building, and we wanted to bring that within. So in terms of the aesthetic, it is a very a high-end, luxurious approach, but it's also around making sure that the building in a whole feels timeless. It has become part of who we are now. It's something that is really driving later living design in a high level way. The inclusions within the apartments are sort of unseen in a later living setting. So really, it's merging that sort of residential and that seniors living component. And I think that's really where we need to be going with seniors and later living design. It's the old stereotype of later living or aged care is a taboo subject. We're breaking that down, and we're breaking it down in such a way that we would like to be part of that. The building itself has become a bit of a friend of ours now. We're getting to the point now where we've mentioned about it being a bittersweet moment when the project is handed over, and so the level of design within it is superior, I believe, to what's out in the marketplace at the moment.